Hallelujah. Dear Heavenly Father, we are so grateful, Lord God, and so privileged to be in your house this afternoon, O Lord. It's a joy, O Lord, to be welcomed, O Lord God, into your presence, O Lord. We thank you, God, for every life, every person here, every family represented here. We thank you, Lord God, that before even we were born, you knew that at a time like this, we would be in your presence on a day like this, O Lord. So we come to receive, O Lord God, from you. We come to receive of what you have already prepared for us, O Lord God. But not just to receive, but we also come to give of ourselves, to give our hearts to you, to give our praise to you, to give our worship to you, O Lord God Almighty. I pray, O Lord God, that as our songs rise to you and bless your heart, O Lord, as we sing of your love, as we rejoice in your goodness and in your mercy and in your grace, I pray, O God, that we would have a fresh revelation and a fresh understanding, O Lord, of how much you love us and who we are in you, O Lord God, through the songs and through the teaching of your word, O Lord. We pray, O Lord God, for an increased knowledge of you, O Lord God, in our midst. And all things be glorified and be exalted, for you alone are worthy. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Let's put our hands together as we praise God this afternoon.
Thank you.
is worthy of all praise. Lord, we thank you for your love. We rejoice in your goodness. We rejoice in your faithfulness. We rejoice that we have been found, found in Christ Jesus. You have called us your own children, and we're here to praise you. Yes, you are.
There's a faith that's testifying. Sends Goliath to his knees. I've seen us praise and rival shackles right off my feet.
Oh, declare that's the power.
That's the power of your name. Just a mention makes a way. Giants fall and strongholds break, and there is healing. That's the power that I claim. He's the same that rolled the grave. There's no power like the mighty name of Jesus.
There's no name. There's a hope.
There's a hope that calls for courage. In the furnace, I'm afraid. The kind of daring expectation that every prayer I make is on an empty grave. That's the There's no power like the mighty.
So that's the power of your name.
That's the power of your name. It's more than strongholds breaking, there is healing. That's the power that I bring. It's the same that Lord bring. There's no power in the name of Jesus. There's no power. There's no power like the mighty. There's no power.
Jesus for my family, I speak the
Gives us confidence, that gives us triumph, that gives us victory. Because you are victorious, Lord. We are victorious, Lord, when we stand on your word, when we stand on the finished work of our Lord Jesus. Come and just go before him this afternoon and speak this name of Jesus over every area of your life. Wherever you feel God leading you to confess the triumph and the victory of our Lord Jesus. Just invite him in. Just invite him in to take full control. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Nothing.
you get shy on me, lift up your song. Cause you've got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. So come on my soul,
come on my soul. Don't you get shy on me, lift up your song. Cause you've got
Father, we lift our voices to say hallelujah to you. We glorify your name, O King of Kings. Receive, may our hallelujah rise to you like a sweet smelling aroma. May our worship rise to you like this, the scent of the evening sacrifice. May it be acceptable in your presence, Lord. We worship you this afternoon. All glory and honor belongs to you, Jesus. We worship you, Father. We give you praise. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Yes, put your hands together for Jesus. Amen. There's an anointing. I feel there's a presence of God in the house today. And I want us to pray for the November babies. If you were born in November, it doesn't matter if you've already been prayed for, you can get a double portion. Amen. So if you were born in November, I would like to request that you rise up on your feet. We have a special blessing for you. We want to speak a blessing in your life. Yes, if you're born in November, yes, God bless you. I was not born in November, but I'm so envious of you right now. Amen. The world is happy you were born. Amen. Because you as a seed of Abraham, you are a blessing, not only to your family, but to your community and to your nation, and even to CLA. We're so glad you were born. Amen. I want us to speak a blessing. Church, let's stretch our hands to these dear ones. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for these November babies, these people that were born in November. We speak a blessing in their lives. Lord, as they are a blessing to us, we bless them. May they be blessed as they rise up. May they be blessed as they go to sleep. May they be blessed in their coming and in their going. Lord, I speak a breakthrough in their life right now. As they begin this new year of their life, as they begin the new year of their lives, may they experience open doors. May doors open automatically in their presence. May they receive, be candidates of divine favor. Let them be favored by man. May they enjoy favor of the Lord. And Lord, I pray that as they seek your face, as they will pray under open heavens. They will operate under open heavens. Their life will be a miracle after miracle. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for these dear ones. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, November babies. You're making us happy this afternoon. And I would like to congratulate all of you that made it for this service. Thank you for braving the rain. I don't know what you are seeking for in the house of God, but you're going to get it today. In Jesus' name. I don't know the miracle, the blessing, whatever, just because you braved the rain. The others who were coming out of the house and they saw the rain and they went back. But you chose to come. May God bless you. Amen. God bless you. Before I say my name, I want to thank the worship team. Thank you, Pastor Prince and the team. These people prayed. They really prepared because you could feel the presence of God as they were leading us in praise and worship. And God bless them. Yeah, my name is Jack Hodari. I'm a pastor on the pastoral team here in CLA in charge of the cell ministry and the discipleship. And I'm glad to be your host this afternoon. Amen. Before we go into the church news, I would like to see those who are worshiping with us for the first time. If you're here and you're worshiping with us for the first time, please raise your hand. Yes, keep your hands up. Oh, we have a number of them. God bless these angels. Yes, we are so happy to have you. There's so many on this side. How about this side? First timers on this side. Oh, they all chose to sit on this side. Looks like this place has more anointing. Yes. our loved ones, we love you. Thank you so much for coming. And Christian Life Assembly, we love you. If you have been looking for a congregation to worship with, or this your and you feel the Spirit of the Lord leading you to worship with us, please, that's the right choice to make. It's the best choice you can make. Make that your seat and be comfortable in it. And if you are moving through, you're just passing through, you're in Kigali, and maybe you said, let me worship with the brethren on Sunday, and then you'll be going back to your station. Please send our regards to the people where you're coming from. Tell them Christian Life Assembly blesses them. And we are happy. And tell them we are praying for them, and we're looking forward to that morning, glorious morning, when Jesus will appear in the sky. And we shall all join him together, and we shall live with him forever and ever. Amen. I've just seen Fabrice. Fabrice, we say hello. Fabrice, we love you. God bless you for coming. As you travel back to Burundi, please. Abashinganai, abatama, namama mubasuhuze. Utragira tutia, uwabgira tutragize ngo yambo. Yeah, amen. God bless you. Yes, before the church news, I've just remembered a wonderful couple that will be wedding next weekend. That is Martin Muhire and Wera Jolie. Are you in the house? Please make your way to the stage. Look how wonderful they are. Amen. See what the Lord has done. The pianist. See what the Lord has done. What we've waited for has come to pass. See what. Let me ask their families. Their family, please come if you are in their cell. You're part of their cell where they worship. Also come and join us. Come quickly. See what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. See what the Lord has done. What we've been waiting. What we waited for has come to pass. See what Lord. Let me ask Pastor Hassan to come and speak a word of blessing to this couple that will be wedding next Sunday.
Hallelujah. Hove, 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 hove. Uh-huh. There you go. All right, Martin, hold the hand of your bride-to-be. I'll ask our pastors in charge of marriage and family just to lay hands on them. Please stretch your hands towards them. Can I ask the congregation, please stretch your hands towards Martin and Jolie, and let's just pray a blessing over them. Father, we thank you for this precious couple, Martin and Jolie, that are intending to make covenant before you and in the witness of many. We thank you for the gift of marriage. We thank you for our church that stands behind those that are intending to get married. We pray, oh God, for this couple, oh God, that you will bless their wedding day, that you will provide for everything they need for that day, that, Lord, everything will go smoothly, that whoever is coming alongside them to serve them and to make sure that the day goes well, that your blessing will be upon them. But beyond their wedding day, we pray for their marriage. We pray that their marriage will be established on you. We pray, oh God, Jesus, that they will be bound like three cord strands, them and you being the third person in their marriage. Strengthen them. We pray for the fruit of the womb of Jolie, that she will bring forth children that will be a joy to them, oh God. We pray that they will raise their children in the ways and admonition of the Lord. And we pray, King of Glory, that they will look to you until death do they part, oh God. And Christ, if you tarry, I pray that they will be established, oh Lord, that they will live to see their children.
The Lord has done. See what the Lord has. What we waited for has come to pass. See what the Lord has. Let's have the church news. Let's have the church news.
Hello, beautiful people, wonderful people. I hope you're doing good just as much as I am. The Bible tells us in Psalms 100 verses 4 that enter his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. So if you're weary, if you're heavy burdened, just relax. God has it in control. My name is Douglas Kamanzi. I serve in the creative arts and I'm super excited to host the church news this Sunday. These are the weekly events. On every Monday, the ladies join in prayer at 5 a.m., 1 p.m., and 10 p.m. And on Tuesday, we have our prayers that happens from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. Wednesday is opened up with a prayerathon that is led and conducted by young people. This happens from 5:15 a.m. to 6 a.m. I am a member and a product of my cell. You may be wondering what cell is all about. Cell is about unity. Cell is about love, cell is about family, and above all, cell is church. So if you are in the congregation and you do not have a cell yet, and you live in Kigali, we have a short briefing immediately after service at the cell information desk. On Thursdays, men also gather for prayers that starts from 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. Intercessory prayers also happen on Friday, and this begins from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. The university students also got something for us, and this happens every other Saturday, the campus fusion, from 5:30 p.m. to 8 p.m.
Hello, parents. As CLA, we are privileged to have the mother's room, a place of tranquility and comfort for mothers and their young ones below 2 years.
However, it has been very difficult in the past few months, where parents who have children who are older than two bring them to this room. Also, we've seen other people who come, church members, who use the facilities that are in these rooms meant for children and their mothers. So as we discourage those who have children over 3 years to bring them in these rooms, we also encourage mothers who have children who are less than 2 years old to bring them to these rooms. But these rooms are not equipped.
We are calling out to parents, friends, church members. if you could please donate play mats, changing tables, toys, or anything that could be used to equip the mother's room. Kindly drop it at church at the reception on from Monday to Friday, anytime between 8 and 5 p.m. Thank you.
Now, this is an important message to you, parent. Kids Ministry will be breaking off after the 10th of December and resume on the 4th of February 2024. Our teens are wrapping up this year in style, and if you attended last True North Garage, you know what I'm talking about. We have a True North Garage again this coming month, December 1st. You ought not to miss out. Check out the highlights, see what happened last time. Christmas is around the corner. When I talk about Christmas, I mean these moments that we've taken a while without experiencing. These wonderful songs that we've taken a while without listening to. But above all, the wonderful message of Christmas. As CLA, we are preparing something for you that will happen on the Christmas Eve here at the auditorium. Make sure you be part of it. Has anybody told you look so stunningly great this day? Yes? Wow, that's so beautiful. No? Like I'm hearing some noise in the church. Don't worry, I got you covered. You are so amazing this day. Now, did you know that you are God's masterpiece? And did you know that this world is a better place because you live in it? Selah. Ponder. My name is Douglas Kamanzi. It's been a pleasure to host the church news this day, and I've not worked alone. I've been with Davis on camera one, and Loic, the brother with the fancy hairstyle, on camera two. And this whole episode of the church news has been directed and edited by Papa Jerken. Papa Jerken, I love the name. Have yourself a very wonderful week, and hope to see you again next Sunday. Merry Christmas and a bountiful 2K24. See you. Peace.
Together for the heavy team. I know Douglas has put a smile on your face just like he did mine. And I agree with him. You people are amazing. You're lovely. You're God's masterpieces. Now, as I've just been reminded, one of the team members of the AV team, the media team, our sister Nicole, she's not here. I don't think she came. She lost her dad. And there's also another brother called Mugisha who also lost a father. A sister called Mugisha. Oh, thank you for the correction. Yes, we are going to quickly pray for these dear ones that lost dear ones. Oh, and any other member of CLA that could have lost a loved one. It's always, the Bible tells us to mourn with those who mourn and rejoice with those who rejoice. Right now, I want us to close our eyes and let's pray for these people, that the Lord will comfort them wherever they are. Father, in the name of Jesus, we speak a special prayer for Nicole and her family as they, through this period of mourning, that Lord, you strengthen them. And also our other sister, Mugisha, that wherever she is, Lord, you strengthen them. You are the Lord of all comfort. You surround them with your warmth of comfort, Lord. Be a father, because you're the father to the fatherless. So be their father, be their parent, and continue to supply all their need according to your riches and glory, because your name is Jehovah Jireh. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We welcome the online community. We welcome you, and I just have three announcements that were not part of the church news. The first announcement is on the Global Leadership Summit that is happening on Tuesday on Tuesday, this Tuesday, the 28th, and on Wednesday, the 29th. It will be happening at New Life Bible Church. And one of our own, Pastor Hassan, is among the speakers there. So feel free to register at the back. You'll find Brother Janti at the back at the registration desk. Register. Last year's was powerful. The past year's global summits were always powerful. So don't miss this one. Yeah, the other announcement I have is this one pertains to the youth. There's a program that is happening hosted by Saddleback Church, but it's happening here. And the title, the theme is Finishing the Task. So if you're a young person, a teenager, a young adult, a young professional, all the way to the Triple R group, you feel welcome to come and be part of the finishing the task. The main speakers are Pastor Rick Warren himself. I thought someone would put your hands together. From Saddleback, and there's another pastor from Saddleback by the names of Reward Sibanda, all from Saddleback, California. So on Saturday at 9 a.m., let's all, those who can make it, the young people, please make your way to CLA for that wonderful time. Then the third announcement is the book. Pastor Hassan, give me that book. Today at 3 p.m., we'll be launching this book. This book was authored by two wonderful men of God here in CLA, by the names of Dr. Donald Ngarambe, PhD, and Dr. Michael Vidyabarema. We all know them. These are elders. We love them, and they love us. So they've demystified. They used, of course, their research acumen. And, these are researchers. They researched the Big Bang. They research those things and those theories that usually the scientists will always want to show that God did not exist. But these men researched and they show that God existed and he created all the universe that you see, everyone that you see. So come at 3 p.m. and these books are at the back. You could, as the service ends, you could pass at the back and buy yourself a copy. But meanwhile, come and listen to these brains. They will be here at 3 p.m. to expound more on these questions. Yeah, God bless you. Now, we've come to the time of worshiping the Lord with our substance. Yeah, we give not because God is poor, but because we give as a way of gratitude from the multitude of the good things that the Lord has done in our lives. And therefore, we give. So the Momo codes will be projected. And also, if you're not able to give with cash, you could give electronically after the service under the Mercy Ministry banner. Let's pray for the offering. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the offering of the children. Thank you for the opportunity to give in your house. Lord, your word says that give and it shall come back to you in good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over. Lord, I pray for everyone that you will give, therefore that you bless them. And I also pray for those who genuinely do not have what to give, that Lord, you bless them, you open doors for them, so that next time when they come into your house, they'll have something to give in your house. We thank you, give you praise. Lord, I also pray for your word that will be ministered to us by our senior pastor. Lord, I pray that you anoint him, that as he speaks, he will not speak of himself, but he will speak as an oracle of the Lord. We thank you, give you praise, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Once you're done giving, just feel free to rise to your feet as we continue to worship God in songs. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Prince and the worship team. Let's appreciate them. Thank you, Mark. Good job. Hello, CLA. Hope you're doing well. Yes, my name's Pr. Peter Nkunzingoma. I serve here as a lead pastor, and I am humbled and delighted to be sharing with us the Word of God. I'm going to be talking about the theme of faith. I'm going to be talking about the theme of faith. How many of us were here last Sunday when the kids were ministering through kids production? God bless. I hope you enjoyed. You enjoyed. Yeah, they somehow alluded to this subject of faith. If you remember very well some of the scenes in their script, particularly I recall one where Joseph and Josephine appeared on stage, and Josephine was talking about the challenges that she had gone through that somehow tried her faith. And she got to a place where she was doubting and wavering in her faith, and many others. And so she was encouraged by Joseph, who had gone through a lot at the same time, but had got stuck to her faith, rather to his faith, that at the end of the day, there was a testimony. He became the second in command in a fallen land. And so we're going to be talking about faith, and I will be taking us through our theme text will be in Hebrews chapter 11, verses 1 to 6. But before I get to that, I want to just lay a background of this letter. The letter of the book of Hebrews in relation to our theme of faith, it is clear that this letter was addressed to the Hebrews or Hebrew believers who were under great persecution and pressure because of their faith, and they were tempted to revert. They were tempted to revert back to the old covenant of Moses or to Judaism. And the author of the book of Hebrews, who is not known, labors to persuade them of the superiority of Jesus Christ. In Hebrews chapter 3, verses 1 to 4, the Bible says that therefore, holy brethren, partakers of the heavenly calling, consider the apostle and the high priest of our confession, Christ Jesus, who was faithful to him who appointed him, as Moses also was faithful in all his house. For this one has been counted worthy of more glory than Moses, inasmuch as he who built has more honor than the house, for every house is built by someone, but he who built all things is God. Okay? So in verse 5 and 6, the writer brings a contrast of who Moses is and who Jesus is. He says that Moses was indeed a faithful servant in his house. That pertained only in the house of Israel. And he goes on to say, for a testimony of the things which would be spoken afterward. But Christ, as a son over his own house, over his own house. The other one had his house, but now Jesus, as a son over his house, whose house we, you, me, and the old covenant people, if we hold fast the confidence and the rejoicing of the hope firm to the end. Let us pray. Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus, we come before your throne today. We thank you for loving us. Thank you for who you are. We place our hearts into your hands as we break your word. And I pray that, Holy Spirit, you will illuminate your word to bring understanding to each and every person that is seated here and even to those that are following us online. Pray that, Lord God, our faith will be encouraged, our faith will be stirred up, our faith will be uplifted in you, that at the end of the day, the Lord, we will have made up our mind not to quit, not to give up, but to press on to the higher calling that you have called us into. We give you praise and glory. In Jesus' mighty name we prayed and believed. Amen. Now, when I was getting ready to share with us this message, a lot of things was going around my mind. And I was, you know, praying and asking God, so what do you want me to talk about? You'll be surprised. Faith is not, the faith that I'm going to be talking about is not the kind of name it, claim it, and have it. I'm going to be talking about the faith that the writer of Hebrew has described in the verses that I'm going to be reading for us. The faith, the kind of faith that will take you through the fire, the kind of faith that will see you through the waters, the kind of faith that will see you through the challenges as you journey through this broken world. Because there are many other times when we get this kind of notion that faith is whatever you pray for is going to come as you have. Sometimes it may not work that way. And as a result, some believers end up getting disappointed. They wonder whether God is real or whether God exists. Praise the Lord. Chapter 11, verses 1 to 6, and I read from New King James Version, says that now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good testimony. Verse 3, by faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God. The worlds were framed. Now, when the Bible is talking about the worlds, it's talking about the heavens and the earth and every created thing were framed by the word of God, by faith. So that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible. By faith, Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, through which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and through it, he, being dead, still speaks. Number 5, by faith, Enoch was taken away, so that he did not see death and was not found, because God had taken him. For before he was taken, he had this testimony that he pleased God. Number 6, but without faith, it is impossible to please God. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. That is the kind of faith that I'm going to be talking. And I am going to be addressing these two important questions that we all need to know. What is faith, therefore? And why is faith important in every believer's life? Now, this is the definition that I got from Merriam-Webster. It defines faith as belief and trust in and reality to God. Belief and trust in and loyalty to God. And B, he says that it's a firm belief in something for which there is no proof. But while I was getting ready, I landed on this message by John MacArthur, is one other theologian, who said that faith is a God-given ability to trust the future that God has promised you in his word. Faith is a God-given ability to trust the future that God has promised you in his word. So it's not about what you can do. It's not about what someone else has said is going to happen to you. But it's about the promise that God has given you through his word. And so verses 1 of Hebrews to verse 3 gives a description of what faith is. It says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for. And I'm going to be illustrating this a little bit further using another text in the book of Daniel chapter 3. From verse 14, I will be getting there in a little while. But I just want to capture something here before I get there. So it says it's a substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And verse 2, he says, for by it the elders, he's talking about the patriarchs, our fathers of faith like Abraham, by it they obtained a good testimony. He's talking about Abel in verse 4. By it he was counted righteousness because of his faith he was able to give a very excellent gift to God. And he also gives a reference to the creation story. So faith is believing things that are not as though they are. Faith does not eliminate the challenges that we go through this life. But faith is that force, that ability that tells you that regardless of what the world has presented before you, God has not changed. He remains faithful. Praise the Lord. He remains faithful. So it does not eliminate the reality that you are facing, but rather faith is that power that will see you through the fire, that will see you through the waters and you'll not be drowned, that will see you through the trials that you are facing. And I am going to be reading with us in the book of Daniel chapter 3 to explain further my point here so that we can all grasp what I mean here today. I will read from verse 14. This is what the Bible says. I want you to follow through. Faith is a substance of things not hoped, rather of things hoped for. Verse 14, I'm reading from New King James Version. The Bible says, Nebuchadnezzar spoke, saying to them, is it true, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you do not serve my gods or worship the gold image which I have set up? Verse 15, now, if you are ready, at the time you hear the sound of the horn, flute, harp, lyre, and psaltery, in symphony with all kinds of music, and you fall down and worship the image which I have made, good. But if you do not worship, you shall be cast immediately into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. And who is the God who will deliver you from my hands? Listen to the response of these young Hebrew boys. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. If that is the case, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fire furnace, and he will deliver us from your hand, O king. But if not, let it be known to you, O king, that we do not serve your gods, nor will we worship the gold image which you have set up. Let me ask you a question. Does God heal? Yes, God heals. Oh, I missed that from you. Does God heal? Yes, he does. In this case, what these three Hebrew guys are saying, they're saying that even if he does not heal me, I will not worship your God. So whether he takes away the sickness or not, he remains God. Nothing is going to change his love for you. Nothing. Now, I don't know where you are apparently in your journey. Probably you could be struggling. But I'm here to encourage you. I'm here to uplift your faith and let you know that it is more than just healing. It's about your soul. Praise the Lord. It's more than just healing. So these boys said that if we know, just like you responded, that he can heal. But even if he will not, we are not going to give up on our faith. That is the kind of faith that I'm bringing to your attention this morning. Even if I don't see what I have believed for in this world, I am not going to let go, my Redeemer. And that is exactly what the writer of Hebrew is describing in Hebrews 1 to 6. It doesn't mean that when you have believed in Jesus, then you're not going to face challenges. They will come. They will come. But what the message is saying to you and me is that keep your eyes fixed onto Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. Keep your eyes there. Keep your faith in him. Do not give up. Do not quit. At the end of the day, the victory belongs to you. Now, let's continue with this story, because it's an interesting story. Verses 19 says, then Nebuchadnezzar was full of fury, so be it, and the expression on his face changed towards Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, but they were not moved. He spoke and commanded that they hit the furnace 7 times, more than it was usually heated. And he commanded certain mighty men of valor. Did you hear that? Who were in his army to bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and cast them into the burning fire furnace. These guys responded. Verse 21, then these men were bound in their coats, their trousers, their turbans, and their garments, and were cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Therefore, because the king's command was urgent, and the furnace exceedingly hot, the flame of the fire killed those men who took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And their story ended there. But the story of these faithful Hebrews is continuing. It's continuing. Praise the Lord. It's continuing. Then King Nebuchadnezzar, I missed something here. 23. And these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down bound into the midst of the burning fire furnace. Then King Nebuchadnezzar was astonished, and he rose in haste and spoke, saying to his counselors, "Did we not cast three men bound into the midst of the fire?" And answered and said to the king, "True, O king." 25, "Look," he answered, "I see four men loose walking in the midst of the fire, and they are not hurt, and the form of the fourth is like the Son of God." Praise the Lord. Their story is being written because they kept their faith in God. They did not let go. They were not moved, even when the fire was rekindled seven times. They held on to their faith in God. And that is what God is speaking to you today. And verse 26 says, "Then Nebuchadnezzar went near the mouth of the burning fiery furnace and spoke, saying, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, servants of the Most High God, come out and come here. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came from the midst of the fire." They came out majestically. And the satraps, administrators, governors, and the king's counselors gathered together, and they saw these men on whose bodies the fire had no power. Can you imagine that? So you will face trials, but you will overcome if you keep your faith in God. So the writer of Hebrews says that it is that assurance of things not seen. It is that conviction that even if I don't get what I want, I have victory at the end of the day. There is that assurance. And he says, after calling them out, "The hair of their head was not singed, nor were their garments affected, and the smell of fire was not on them." And Nebuchadnezzar spoke in verse 28, saying, "Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sent his angel and delivered his servants, who trusted in him," who trusted in him. Will you trust in the Lord? Will you have your faith in him? Will you, you know, have that faith that is immovable? Praise the Lord. "I do not know what your world is like, but I want to encourage you that in heaven there is a God who will deliver you. And even if he does not deliver you, he will be with you in that fire. He will walk with you in that pain. He will restore you. He is our Redeemer. He is our healer. He is our deliverer. He is our strong tower. He is the Peter, just like he was to the children of Israel." This world could be painting a lot of scenarios before you. You could be going through hard times, but hold on to your faith in him. Do not give up. Do not quit. The Bible says that he will sympathize with us because he has gone through much more, actually. For your sake, not because he was a sinner, but because he wanted to identify with us. He came. So he who has gone through that is the chief high priest. He will sympathize with us. He understands. And if we will not give up, he is going to wipe away our tears on that day. So, let's understand that we are on a race. We are on a battlefield. We will face all these challenges and trials. But he who is in us is greater than the devil that is in the world. And he has given us that promise that if we don't give up, we will be saved. Let me finish this text and I go back to my message. He says, I repeat, verse 28, Nebuchadnezzar spoke, saying, "Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sent his angel and delivered his servants who trusted in him, and they have frustrated the king's word and yielded their bodies, that they should not serve nor worship any god except their own God." Except their own God. Their own God, the creator of all things, our Savior, our Redeemer. Praise the Lord. 29 says, therefore, I love this part. Therefore, I make a decree that any people, nation, or language which speaks anything amiss against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be cut in pieces, and their houses shall be made an ash heap, because there is no other God who can deliver like this. It's a testimony. It's a testimony. Were they bound? Yes. Were they thrown in the fire? Yes. But while they were in that fire, there was the fourth person who looked like the Son of God. So in this world, we are going to face all sorts of trials. But hold on to your faith, because amidst that trial, you have Jesus with you. You have him right with you, right with you, right with you. Sometimes we think he's very far. He is right with you, right with you, ready to walk you through the fire. Very quickly, before I go to my next part, this is what Martin Luther says. He says that faith is a living, daring confidence in God's grace. That's it. Faith is a living, daring confidence in God's grace, so sure and certain that a man could stake his life on it 1,000 times. That is the kind of faith that I am preaching to you today. It doesn't matter what the world is painting, what circumstances look like around you. Have faith in God. Don't give up. Don't be bribed by this temporary stuff. There is more that God has for you in store. So, why is faith important in a believer's life? Why is faith important? We've seen that faith, if I may say it in few words, is you trusting in God. Trusting in God no matter what. Trusting in God even when you are not seeing what you are believing for. Just trust that God is in control. Why is faith important? One, faith pleases God. Faith pleases God. The Bible says in verse 6 of Hebrews chapter 11, it says that without faith, it is impossible to please God. And it says, for he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. So, it is important for you and me to have faith in order to please God, in order to move God. Praise the Lord. To work. You know, Romans chapter 1, verse 17 says that the just shall live by faith. You need faith. Number two, faith guarantee or guarant, well, I'm looking for the word, guarantee our destiny of eternal life, because our hope of eternal life is right in his hands. So it's kind of a guarantor. I'm trying to wrestle with this. Yes. But it's a guarantor. Yeah? Your destiny is through faith in Jesus Christ. You lose that, you lose everything. You lose your faith, just know that you're ready meat for the devil. He will take you into alcohol and you drink your head off. He will take you into immorality and you'll forget that you are a human being. That is who he is. He came to steal, kill, and destroy. Hold on to your faith to the end, and you shall be saved. The Bible says in verse 5 of the same text, that by faith Enoch was taken away, so that he did not see death and was not found, because God had taken him. For before he was taken, he had this testimony that he pleased God. You know what that means? The Bible says when we look back into the Old Testament, that he walked with God. Enoch walked with God. Was the world crazy as it is today? Yes. But he remained faithful to God. And because of that, God was pleased with him, and he did not see death. Took him. Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 and 9, it says, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is a gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. In other words, just put your faith in him. If you do not have any relationship with Jesus Christ, I dare say, do not walk out of this place the same way that you came. We are here to help you. We are here to guide you. And number three is that it is through faith in Christ that we are counted righteous. Verses 4 says, by faith Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, and through which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and through it, being dead, still speaks. Did he terminate the challenges of his brother being jealous of him? No. But God counted him righteous. God still has him on record. His story is still being read up to today. Faith will keep you going amidst the trials. Hebrews 4, I'm about to conclude, 14 to 16 says that, seeing then that we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus the Son of God, let us hold fast our confession. Let us hold fast our confession. For we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. And he says, let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Jesus is waiting on you today, and he wants to help you. His arms are open. He wants to uplift you in your faith. He wants to encourage you. Hebrews 10, 35 to 38, the Bible says, therefore, do not cast away your confidence. Do not cast away your confidence, which has great reward. For you have need of endurance, so that after you have done the will of God, you may receive the promise. 37, for yet a little while, and he who is coming will come and will not tarry. Now, the just shall live by faith. But if anyone draws back, my soul has no pleasure in him. Do not quit. Do not give up. Do not draw back. Keep moving on. Keep holding on to your faith. And I want to say this with all humility. Do not sell your birthright. Don't compromise your faith. Don't compromise your faith. Hold on to it to the end. You know, when we give our lives to Jesus, many other times when we think that we've got it, it's just the beginning. It was the same for Abednego, Shadrach, and Meshach. What determines your victory is when you hold on to your faith until when Christ returns or until you breathe your last. Praise the Lord. Then you leave behind a testimony, a good testimony. Praise the Lord. I am concluding because my time is up. Hebrews chapter 12, verses 1 and 2 says, therefore we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who, for the joy that was set before him, endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. He will wipe away our tears. Praise the Lord. He will wipe away your tears. It doesn't matter the circumstances that you're going through. Hold on to your faith. Shall we rise on our feet and pray? The Bible says that without faith, it's impossible to please him. And I want to pray with somebody here. Probably you have got pressed to the wall and somehow you've doubted God. Your faith has kind of wavered. And, you know, you're not stable. Or you're about to quit. God still loves you. Or you could be here and probably you have not opened the door of your heart to receive Jesus in your heart, to walk with you this journey. You cannot stand the challenges. I want to give you this opportunity. After the service, please make your way here. We'll be waiting to help you. But I want to pray for those that are struggling in their faith. Father in heaven, we come before your throne today. And we know that, Lord, you never change. You're immutable. You're forever the same. The Bible says you're the same God yesterday, today, and forever. Same God that was with Abednego, Shadrach, and Meshach. Same God that is with us today. I want to pray for the person that, Lord, has experienced a trying moment, a difficult time that has thrown them to a place of doubt or wavering in their faith. That Jesus, you will encourage them. That Jesus, you will encourage them. That Jesus, you will strengthen their faith. That we will be able to press on, knowing well that you did not give up on us, and we ought not to quit in trusting in you. We give you praise, glory, and honor. In Jesus' mighty name we prayed. Amen. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Amen. If those hands were for the Lord, there are very few. Let's put our hands together to God for the message you received. Yeah, it was a message of the season, the message of these times, the message of faith. God bless you, Pastor Peter, for that message. We've come to the end of our service, but before we leave, just four quick verbals. If you came late and you didn't get the opportunity to give, to worship the Lord with your substance, There's an offering slot at the back on my towards the end. You'll see it's lit, offering slot. And as you exit on this side, also there's a slot. You could slot in your offering on a place labeled tithe and offering. And also those who would like to give by POS, if you have your MasterCard and Visa card, Sister Jackie will be waiting for you at the back under the Mercy Ministry banner to help you on that. First-time visitors, a good number of you. Yes, we're happy to have you in our service today. Please don't be quick to leave. Make your way to the hospitality room, clearly marked on that door, and our team will be there to discuss more about our church with you. And yes, if you are here and you do not belong to a cell, I encourage you to be part of that church that happens on Wednesday in the evening in our houses. So under the cell information corner, you will find information there. There will be someone there to help you, guide you to a cell that is in your neighborhood. And as you do so, God bless you. Yeah, with that, let me ask that you raise up on our feet. We share the words of grace and we make our way out. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen. Go in power. Go with the blessing of the Lord. May you prosper this week. May you enjoy God's favor before man and before the Lord. In Jesus' name.